Hi, my name is Eric Ruck. I am an ex-world champion, an ex-pro tour champion, and someone that loves to be on the water. Back in the day, we were all together, and I got an opportunity to join the team, and things just happened to work out, and it's just a blessing that I get to work and ride with the guys that, you know, most feel like family. So kind of timing-wise, everything worked out to a T because basically the pioneers of Flexboards were working on a new project. It just happened that I was able to work with them, and we got the Phoenix project. And the whole Flexboard thing is basically the direction that I have been slowly gravitating towards, just more or less wake park and more or less a versatile way of riding. When I was riding this board, I could actually feel the transfer of the energy going from the nose of the board to the tail of the board the longer I waited as I was cutting through the wake. If you've never ridden a flex board before, kind of the feeling is it's a little bit more like of a free feeling. It's a later pop, more of an ollie style board rather than an edge through the wake style board. You're gonna kind of have a little bit more snowboard feel where you're a little bit later on your pop, feeling the energy transfer from the nose to the tail, and you have your more of a snappy pop rather than creating pressure through the boat and rope pop. The one thing that's cool about this board when you land is that the energy is carrying through it, and also it has a lot of rigidity to it. So you're landing and you're not slowing down, you're actually speeding up. It has a lot of coast to it. Like when you kind of take a whip on this thing, you can feel it speeding up as you kind of get slack rather than slowing down like a three-stage board would. One of the reasons this board has a very smooth landing is that it's controlled flex. A lot of flex boards are super loose when you land and they get a little sketchy. This board lands in tracks and just lands like a normal wakeboard. One of the cool things about the blended glass is that you can actually feel the energy being transferred through the board as you're riding it. Whether you're pressing the board and you're up on your nose, and you can actually feel the balance point of where the board flexes and catches itself, to where also through when you're edging through the wake, and you can feel the energy transfer from the nose through the tail as you're loading the back of the board. It also has a unique beveled edge, which tapers into a hard, fast rail, which is good for wake riding and cable riding. Well, on a normal wakeboard, when you're ollieing up onto a rail, more or less what you feel is you ollie up and kind of rock the board into position to press. You're more or less pivoting on the board rather than pressing. On the Phoenix, what you're feeling is when you ollie into a rail and you go for a press, you're ollieing into the press and the board is flexing and you're kind of hitting your balance point and you're kind of feeling the energy of the board locking you into that press rather than just pivoting against the rail. The proven center base is the most durable bottom without a lot of drag on the water. The board comes with 8 fins. One set of 4 is a narrower profile for riding behind the boat, a little cleaner release of water. Then also it comes with a rail fin that is a little bit wider, bulletproof on rails, and is designed for that skate style rider. If you're into a board that carries a lot of energy, has a late kick, and is super versatile on rails, Phoenix Project's your board.